Welcome to this week's weather report. In the world today, you've got this guy's pants still on the ground. Brett Favre's pants, however, are still holding his pocket watch, a dusty handkerchief, and his wrinkly balls.
Pants on the ground! Pants on the ground! Pants on the ground! Hands to the side! Pants going down!
In other parts of the world, Leno and Conan are still fighting over the spot on The Tonight Show. Leno has the upper hand, thanks to the No Jello on Tuesdays rebellion, led by 95-year-old Betsy Thomas. Betsy Thomas was found punching a grandmother of a Conan fan.
Harry has PhD.
On the West Coast, we can see how Taylor Swift beat out Lady Gaga for the Grammy of Album of the Year. Unlike Lady Gaga, who has balls, this two-faced good-for-nothing slut has done nothing for humanity. She can't even write.
Yo, Taylor, I'm really happy for you. I'm gonna let you finish. But Beyonce had one of the best videos of all time.
This is Leche with your weekly weather.
I don't know what happened there. I thought our technology was much better than that.
Hey.
Just looks like a fucked up onion.
Yeah.
Have you seen the onion?
Yeah.
I love the onion.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that's it for us. We got a little freestyle, and then I'm going to go on with Carolyn Pickman, casting agent here in Boston. We're going to interview her right now.
Yeah, casting director.
Yeah, director. Yeah, that's it. So just don't forget to become a fan on Facebook, subscribe on YouTube, and keep watching us.
Mm.
Every night. Night. Night.
Oh, I love this beat.
Tonight.
I love this beat.
Tonight. Now I was walking on the street tonight. I'm not dissing, but I'm missing.
Oh,
the
yeah.
Thing you should be pissing on my wrist. You missing?
Yeah. I really like this beat. Now just drop it. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm British. Ginger spice. It's British.
Fuck Scotland.
Yeah.
Fuck Ireland.
We got British people all over the place. Yeah.
Bring it up for
British
the show.
People.
We're
yeah.
coming back in. You'll know. You know if we're gonna throw. We're gonna throw some blow. Blow it back. Bring it back. Bring it back.
Yeah.
I'm walking on the streets of London.
London.
I'm looking at the people. They're all making faces at me. Because they know who I am. They know who I am.
I like her British breast. Every pot, everything's British.
Oh.
I like it because I like British.
Yes.
British people. The British people.
The British people.
Yeah.
The British people.
Not
French
people.
The people.
Not
the
people.
I'm one of those British
people.
I'm one of those
spies.
Who wants to be spies? I love you. Carolyn Pickman, right here. Right here, Carolyn.
We'll be back. Can't pick me.
All right. Welcome back. I'm here with Carolyn Pickman. Carolyn, thank you
Hi.
For being on the show.
Thanks for asking me to be here.
Carolyn is a casting director here in Boston, in New England.
Right.
And tell me just a brief description of what you do, Carolyn.
Well, I work on feature films, I work on commercials, and I work on corporate videos, and I match the people up with the part.
Okay.
And most of my job happens during pre-production, and I look for my talent in the whole entire New England area, so I am a local casting person.
Okay, so you got people from New England?
I got people from Boston.
I got a pretty good Boston accent, you know.
keep it coming.
I can talk throughout the interview with the Boston accent, you know.
Well, that's not so bad.
Well, Carolyn, tell us.
Sounds a little Cockney, but.
I try. So tell us a little bit about what new feature film is coming out that people could be interested in.
Well, we just got finished working on a great project. It's a movie called The Town. It was partly written and wholly directed by Ben Affleck. And we had previously worked with Ben on the movie Gone Baby Gone. Great movie. And so this is a carryover of our time with Ben. And he likes to find actors, but he also likes to go into the real world. And since this was a movie about Charlestown bank robbers and the code of silence that happens in neighborhoods, we were in the Charlestown neighborhood a lot. And of it, yeah.
So that's really great. Cool.
Yeah, we did the principals and we did the extras, and there was another casting director out of Los Angeles who did a few of the sort of star kind of people, but that's not what we do. So.
And tell me, like, this isn't like there's been a big wave of movies coming in through Boston.
There has been, and what with the tightening of the belt of economy, that we may find that some of that's going to be cut back a little bit, but it has brought a lot of movies into town, and
the new Hollywood East, they say it's going to be.
I
think they're building like a sign or something.
Yes,
I heard.
I don't think
maybe
that they've started on that sign yet, but
it's a little
what
too precipitated.
It has done is a lot of independent features and a lot of low budget features have been able to finally come to fruition and actually been able to shoot, and so because of the tax incentive that's come here, so it's been fantastic. You know, it's given us a lot of work. It's taught us a lot about the movie industry. It's given a lot of people their first jobs in the feature film industry. So
always good to have new jobs.
Yes,
I just got some new writers in the back.
Oh yeah,
they're good people.
Good,
yeah.
Good. Don't work them too hard.
Yeah, no, they're good. They're fine. They'll be fine.
Well. That's that. You need that. You need in a script. You need a good writer. That's the mainstay of a good script. Actually.
Well, I haven't really improved on my jokes, but I'll get there. One last question, Carolyn. What do you think of the kids these days?
Kids.
The fucking kids these days are doing whatever they want.
The kids are doing a lot, and there's a lot of coming out of the universities. Kids who used to go into the theater are now kind of moving a little bit away from the theater. That breaks us heart a little bit, but feature films are one of the largest export industries in this country, you know, and so why wouldn't they be turning their sights to making movies? And they can make a movie on their phone, for goodness sake.
On HD, even. That's ridiculous.
On HD. The technology is just so vast, and who better yet to know that technology is the young kids who have been brought up with it. So,
right.
So I have no problem with them making movies at all.
Yeah. Hopefully someone will come up with something good eventually.
Oh, sure.
Yeah. Well, Carolyn, thanks so much for being on the show.
Well, my pleasure.
We hope you watch us.
Yes. Keep sending me those emails reminding me.
I will. If you see Ben Affleck, tell him to return my calls.
Why aren't you returning his calls? He's a nice guy. For goodness sake.
I guess so. His voicemail is just off the hook. Well, thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to become a fan on Facebook, subscribe on YouTube, and catch us next week for another exciting episode of The Leche Show.
Day and night, I toss and turn, I keep stressing my mind. I look for peace, but see, I don't attain. What I need for keeps this silly game we play. Now look at this.
Madness the magnet keeps attracting me.